Book now, save up to 50%. Call your travel agent or 1-800-SANDALS.
Man, didn't that look great? I'd love to go to Jamaica. What's this one about?
In another daylight gun by 2 youths were shot dead by unknown assailants in Kingston.
Out in the street, they call it
That video wasn't as glamorous looking as the other one. I wonder why that is. Scratch that. I know why that is. Of course Jamaica wouldn't want what some consider poverty to be the first image one would think of when hearing of Jamaica. They want to see soft beds, dancing people, selfies, and drinks on the beach. That's not a bad thing. What is a bad thing, however, is ignoring the rest of Jamaican culture. Accepting the good and dismissing the bad. But the focus isn't just on Jamaica, it's on the whole world. People unconsciously assimilate parts of other cultures. And it's gonna happen as long as goods are imported and exported. This video is gonna highlight this assimilation, or in a better term, commodification. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to look at the commodification of culture and what comes out of this. Cultural assimilation is when the characteristics of one culture start to resemble those of another. For example, with music, of course, we hear the influence of one culture in the music of another. Some may even go as far as to choose to identify as whatever culture they may adopt. We see this many times when discussing religion, but sometimes people only choose to adopt part of a culture and not all of it. Aspects of a culture can become popular or cool to people. This is where commodification comes in. The media can destroy community and fashion solitude by turning spectators into atomized consumers or self-entertaining monads. And when they see all the different ways they can represent themselves, they eagerly latch onto them. The desire to be cool transcends social, cultural, and financial boundaries. That brings me to our next part. We tend to ignore negative associations within cultures. This is especially the case when we travel. Many countries have special tourist-associated spots with everything they would need on their visit, leaving no reason to visit the rest of the country. It draws a line between the culture, separating it into what people want to accept and what people don't. And what people don't accept is sometimes never seen. When it comes to foreign and the other, we still think the camera does not lie and all is as we see it. But what we see is not all there is. Let's tie this to part 3, stereotypes. Sometimes, the only part of a culture that is seen is the negative aspects. This occurrence leads to the idea that the entire culture must be associated with negativity. We can call this stereotyping. Identity is most commonly and excessively expressed through symbols that are felt to represent a group. These symbols can be identified and immediately be translated negatively. We can relate this to something called commodity racism. Commodity racism became distinct from scientific racism in its capacity to expand beyond the literate, propertied elite through the marketing of commodity spectacle. Basically, this ties into the idea of stereotyping because from a certain viewpoint, one group or culture associated with a commodity can become judgmental or speculative of another group associated with a different commodity, no commodity at all. So what's the point? Well, like Sir Bernie said, what we see is not all there is. The mass commodification of a country's culture may impair what it stands for. We've become accustomed to saying we understand countries and their culture, and even going as far to accept them without truly knowing all the facts. This partial assimilation is dividing culture in half and warping its meaning, turning many beloved rituals to reasons for a party.